What are some ahas, what are some things counterintuitive that you know that people may not realize about this whole situation we're in? What good is going to come out of these tough times?
Well, I mean, I think the pandemic got the world's attention about the risk of infectious diseases, and I think we put a lot of things in place that are going to help us in the future. We also identified a lot of gaps in the system that need to be addressed before potentially a worse version of this virus or worse virus comes out. So it's put us on high alert. It's, you know, put the attention where it needed to be, where it always needed to be, and it's the question of whether or not we capitalize on it.
If you could go back in time and do something different over the last 2 years, is there anything you would have stood on the top of a mountain and say, you know, follow me this way?
Yeah, sure. I mean, I think, we, you know, people did, and there was just a lot of noise in the system. So, you know, I think for me, actually, this was an instance where there were so many people working and like the tide was just overwhelming that I kind of got small and just address the things I could address. So I think, you know, it's an interesting thing when like every person was a COVID expert, any person with any background was advising their school, their community there. So it was just different. It was a different place where I wasn't trying to stand on top of a mountain. We were just trying to stay close to it and see what we could do.
Talk about your team. How have you made up your team? It's an awesome team. What are you looking for in bringing the talent together? How do you help them solve problems? Do you take credit for what they do? Do they take credit for what you do? What's the dynamic there? Because you're not an industry, but you're doing some real important work.
I run a lab based at the Broad Institute, and it's an awesome collective of folks from lots of different backgrounds, from physicists, computer scientists, geneticists, virologists, folks in public health and medicine. And so it's a collective. We're a team.
How many?
You know, it's close to 60 now, so it's a big group for an academic lab, but it's kind of got a lot of different kind of components to it, and just a lot of management, policy, all sorts of pieces to it. So it's sort of its own like center now, but we work collectively. And I think one of the greatest joys of being a professor is supporting and celebrating and recognizing the contributions of the people that I work with. So I try to really celebrate them. I'm really proud today. One of my team members was just profiled in the New York Times, and like that to me is like the great success, where you are able to show and showcase the folks in your lab and what they're doing.
So you're one of the time 100. Has that been consistent, or just 1 year and then you got dropped off? And did that change, or did that change who you were, how you saw yourself, how people saw you, or who the hell cares?
It was an interesting piece of recognition. It happened during the Ebola outbreak. And we got, we, my lab, got that recognition for sharing genomic data very early that showed that the virus was mutating and it was transmitting from human to human, and the fact that we shared the data publicly right away. And for me, it was like a very strange moment in time because it was a lot of personal recognition on the back of tragedy. And so you don't feel like good about that, right? What I was proud of is that we were being recognized for the fact that we shared our data pre-publication to the world to say, we were actually trying not to get recognition, which is what got recognition. So it was sort of an interesting kind of piece. But since that time, I think we still work the same way, which is we're not trying to, we're just trying to find where we can contribute in meaningful ways. And like I said, think small, think about each piece of the puzzle, because there's a long game. When you kind of talk about what do we need to do, what do we need to think about in the context of like what this is and what it's told us? It told us that there's a lot of gaps in the system, and one of the biggest ones is our culture. The fact that we humans, we Americans, we can't get it together, we can't trust each other, we don't talk to each other the right way. I think those are the big things that we really need to think about. And to me, that's all I care about. I'm thinking about how do we solve those problems so we work better together. You know, the fact of the matter is an outbreak is a very bizarre event that brings out sometimes the worst of us, right? There's an insidious, deadly threat that weaponizes your neighbor against you. And there's also perverse capitalistic incentives that take over that make it so people are going for money, fame, recognition, and all of those things. And there is a lot that makes it really hard to do good work in this time that we need to sort out.
Great. So three questions. One, what's it like being in a rock band? Two, how's the ecosystem in Boston? You know, some have said, we won the Stanley Cup once recently and people are mad we're not winning it more. Others are saying we're winning the Stanley Cup in life sciences. This is a good ecosystem, or are people backstabbing and hiding books in the library? And then third, we have some mutual friends, and some of them say you're the smartest person they know, and your sister and so on. How did you become you? Like you were like one of those child prodigies that grew up to run a lab of 60 that's doing some of the most important work. You look like you're 25. How did you get to that role for people who have daughters who want to be leaders in the STEM world, who want to like have impact? How do they become you?
That's a lot of questions. All right, hold on a second. Where do we get? We'll start.
Rock
well, thank
band,
you. Yeah, the rock band.
Ecosystem, so, okay, yeah. And how to, and
I got
you.
So I do. I like being in a rock band. I think in general, it's for me. That kind of creativity and being in a band is what keeps me going in times like this. And I think that there's a lot of creativity in science too, and I think it all kind of comes together. So for me, I really encourage my students to have outlets, and that's really important, and I enjoy that part of myself. As far as the Boston ecosystem, I mean, it's amazing. It's got some of the most brilliant people in the world. We just saw it. We're seeing it all, you know, today, and it's amazing, and this collective you've created is a showcase of that. When I look individually at all the things that we've accomplished in this outbreak, it's overwhelming. There are a lot of places where we could have been more coordinated, more working together, and I think there's a lot of silos here in Boston. There are a lot of things that have happened here that have been breakthroughs, something called the Massachusetts Consortium for Pathogen Readiness that stemmed out of Harvard Medical School but essentially became a collective of schools across Massachusetts was remarkable. So there was a lot of the collective energy of working together, but I think that's one of the things we don't do as well as we could, is work together well and each play a part, you know, be in a band, really, and not feel like each person needs to be a singer-songwriter and lead their own thing.
And you're the lead singer in your band?
I am, but I joined to be the bass player. I actually joined, yeah, so I prefer not that role.
Well, tell them the name, so if they want to
It's called Thousand Days.
You what's your background? How did you become you? This is the last question.
Yeah, no, right.
Cool glasses.
Thank you. Well, I was born in Iran. I came here.
Persian diaspora.
There you go. I came here as a child of the revolution.
We have a dentist later tonight in the Supernova block who is Iranian dentist.
Okay. All right. Yeah, that's a lot of good dentist doctors in Persian. So that's fantastic and excited about that. I came as a refugee. I think there's a lot of benefits you have when you come, when you're thrust about in the world and everything, all the bets are off, right? So I got to become a scientist who plays in a rock band and does a lot of other kind of random things because I was not born of this culture. I didn't know that girls don't do math. I didn't know that, you know, you can't just sort of like walk into a band or play football. I didn't know any of those things, so I just did them. So I think that is the amazing thing about America, the melting pot that it is. And I think it's what I like love about the my upbringing here and why I'm so like motivated and inspired by it, but also protective of it and kind of see it going a little wonky right now and it needs a little help and love.
Great. Thank you. One of my favorite doctors. Thank you very much.